We were just looking at the section in the Ashtadhyayi which runs from 242 down to 2411. This section lists the conditions under which a dvandvaha compound has to be constructed only samahare and not itare tarayoge. We studied the rules 242, dvandvascha prani turya senanganam, and 246, jatira praninam, and 249, yeshancha virodha shashvatikaha. Following this section, there is the sutram 2412, which we have previously referred to. Sutram 2412 contains the mention of vibhasha, meaning optionally, which in the present context means that the dvandvaha compound may optionally express a samaharaha in the conditions mentioned in that sutram 2412. So under the conditions mentioned in the sutram 2412, dvandvaha compound may express a samaharaha or itare tarayogaha. The anuvritti of vibhasha comes down to the sutram 2413, which is the sutram we are going to take now. Sutram 2413 says, Vipratishiddhancha nadhikarana vachi. The vritti says, Viruddharthanam adravya vachinan dvandva ekavadva. Viruddharthanam adravya vachinam dvandvaha ekavadva. Which means a dvandva compound whose terms have opposite meanings and do not denote physical objects is optionally singular in number, and hence expresses either a samaharaha, a group in which the individuality of the terms is subservient to the group, or itare tarayogaha, a group in which the individuality of the terms is evident. For example, shitam choshnam chanayoho samaharaha, shitam cha ushnam cha anayoho samaharaha equals shitoshnam, a group of cold and hot. This is a group in which the individuality of the terms is subservient to the group. So this expresses a samaharaha. Or we could optionally have shitam choshnam chetare tarayogaha, shitam cha ushnam cha itare tarayogaha equals shitoshne, a group of cold and hot, but this is the group in which the individuality of the terms is evident. So this expresses a itare tarayogaha. The alaukika vigraha is shita su plus ushna su. Compounding, of course, prescribed by the sutram 2229. Charthe dvandvaha. Now the question comes, which term should be placed in the prior position in the compound? Since ushna begins with a vowel and ends in the letter a, as per the sutram 2233, ajadya dantam, ushna should actually be placed in the prior position in this compound. But since we find the usage shitoshnam in the Mahabhashyam, we instead place the term shita-su in the prior position in this compound. So based on the authority of the Mahabhashyam, we override the rule 2233. Okay, now shita-su plus ushna-su gets the designation pradipadikam by 1246 krittadita samasascha. This allows us to apply 2471. Supodhatu Pradipadikayoho, perform the look elision, the sup affixes su and su, which are inside the compound Pradipadikam. So now we have Shita plus Ushna, then we apply Adgunaha to get Shitoshna. Since the terms of this Dvandvaha compound have opposite meanings and do not denote physical objects, it is optionally singular in number and hence expresses either a Samaharaha or itare itara yogaha, as per the present sutram 2413. So the conditions for applying the present sutram 2413 are satisfied. We do have the terms of a dvandvaha compound which express opposite meanings and they are not referring to physical objects. When this compound expresses a samaharaha, it is singular in number. A samahara is always ekavad, singular in number. And as per the sutram 2417, sanpumsakam, it is neuter in gender and hence declines like vanashabdaha, but only in the singular. On the other hand, when this compound expresses itare itare yogaha, it is dual in number, because it has two members. As per Sutram 2426, Paravalingan Dvandvatat Purushayoho, its gender is the same as the gender of the final member of the compound, which in the present example is neuter. And hence the compound is neuter in gender, declined like Vana Shabdaha. The question comes now, why do we need this Sutram? Because as per Sutram 2229, Charthe Dvandvaha, Dvandvaha compound may express either a Samaharaha or Itaretara Yogaha. So the optionality is already available by 2229. Then why bother with this sutra? The next note answers that question. It says, Vaikalpikaha Samahara Dvandvaha Charthe Dvandvaha Iti Sutrena Praptaha Saha Viruddharthanam Yadi Bhavati Tarhi Adravyavachinam Eva Iti Niyamartham Idam. Meaning that Dvandvaha compound optionally expressing a Samaharaha is already available by the sutram 2229 Charthe Dvandvaha. The present sutra is for the purpose of the following restriction. It's Niyamartham. Restriction is that if the terms of the Dvandvaha compound have opposite meanings, then it can optionally express a Samaharaha only if the terms do not denote physical objects. The note further says, Tena Dravyavachinam Itaretara Yogaha Eva. Thus, if the terms of the Dvandvaha compound have opposite meanings and denote physical objects, then the compound can express Itaretara Yogaha only and not Samaharaha. For example, Shitoshne Udake Staha. There are cold and hot waters. So, here the members of the Dvandvaha compound have opposite meanings and they do denote physical objects. Therefore, the compound may only express a Itaretara Yogaha. That is the purpose of this sutram. Without this sutram, this compound would express either Itaretara Yogaha or Samaharaha. But now this sutram says that there is a Niyamaha, restriction. Since the members of the compound denote opposite meanings and they refer to physical objects, the compound has to be only Itaretara Yoga. That is the purpose of this sutram. It is not to prescribe optionality, but to restrict Dvandvaha compound to only express Itaretara Yogaha when its members express opposite meanings and refer to physical objects. Okay, the last note here says that Vipratishiddham Kim. Why does the sutram 2413 mention the condition Vipratishiddham, meaning opposite meanings? Consider the example Nandakascha Panchajanyascha equals Nandaka Panchajanyau, the sword and the conch of Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu's sword is called Nandakaha, the conch is called Panchajanyaha. Since Nandaka and Panchajanya do not have opposite meanings, the Sutram 2413 does not apply. Nandaka and Panchajanya refer to physical objects, but they do not express opposite meanings. The restriction implied in 2413 does not apply here. This is the important distinction between the present example Nandaka Panchajanyau and the prior example Shitoshne Udake Staha. There was a restriction because the members of the compound were expressing physical objects and they had opposite meanings. In the present example, the members of the compound denote physical objects but the meanings are not opposite and hence there is no restriction. The note continues by clarifying that Iha Pakshikaha Samahara Dvandvaha Bhavati Eva. Since there is no restriction, we may also optionally construct Dvandvaha compound Nandaka Panchajanyam expressing a Samaharaha as allowed by the Sutram 2229 Charthe Dvandvaha. So basically, once the Sutram 2413 does not apply, there is no restriction because this Dvandvaha compound has members which do not express opposite meanings. So then we go back to the usual optionality in 2229 Charthe Dvandvaha. So we may have either Itaretara Yogaha as in Nandaka Panchajanyau or Samaharaha as Nandaka Panchajanyam.